Major funding for New Jersey Playhouse was provided by the New Jersey State Council on the Arts. Additional funding was provided by the Geraldine R. Dodge Foundation.
Pick up the paper and read about two old folks decide to act foolish and get married. But don't you worry none about this old hen. Oh, I appreciate that, honey. But I'm just fine. All right. Bye now. Oh, my.
I beg your pardon, ma'am. I didn't mean to barge in.
Well, you didn't. I mean,
I'm called Malin Patterson.
Can I help you, Mr. Patterson?
Matter of fact, I'd appreciate it if you would. You have a room to rent, I believe?
Oh, yes. Well, won't you come on in? You have to excuse my manners having you stand out there like the postman.
Oh, that's quite all right, ma'am.
I was on the phone, don't you know, talking to my niece in Connecticut. And, well, to tell you the truth, I wasn't expecting a gentleman at my door. Won't you sit down?
One of the gentlemen from the church, Mr. Holloway.
Oh, Ostell Holloway. He's a mighty nice man.
Well, he informed me that you might have a room to rent.
Well, I do, but I was hoping to let it to a lady.
Not Miss,
Frazier. It's Miss Frazier.
Well, Mrs. Frazier.
Oh, Miss Lydia. Most people call me Miss Lydia. I guess it's kind of a nickname, but they've always called me Miss Lydia.
Then, Miss Lydia, don't you worry about a thing. I mean, about me being a man and all. I can see you keep a Christian home, and I'm going to respect that. Yes, I am. Matter of fact, lots of things I can do to make things a little easier for you, don't you know? I ain't boasting, but I done been everything that a man can be. You know what I mean? Oh, carpenter. Blacksmith, even do a little roofing every now and then. Live long enough, a man learns to do lots of things.
Well, I appreciate your offer, Mr. Patterson, but see, I wasn't really looking for nobody to do
well,
no
I
work.
Well, I sure ain't one to stand around and watch you doing no lifting and loading. Oh. And I mean that, too. I know Brother Holloway be coming over here once in a while and doing little things around the house to help out, don't you know? He's a fine one for helping out. I know all that, but I mean to pitch in and take some of them worries and concerns off your mind.
He said I was a worryation.
Not to me, did it? Fact is, I just see his truck parked out in front of the house sometimes, and knowing how willing he is to do his part, I just figured he was helping. No, Miss Frazier, I want you to know, I ain't coming in here just to be no rumor. No, sir. When I stay someplace, I share the responsibility. I share the home.
Oh, that's mighty nice of you. You know, you ought to be the one collecting the rent. I mean, most rumors ain't so willing.
Well, I mean, I don't want you to think I'm pushing, Miss Frazier. I mean, I know my place.
Well, I didn't mean it like that. What I meant to say was that most rumors, of course, I never had none before, but I don't suppose they'd be all.
And they don't either. I used to live with Miss Sally Hempstead over on Harrison, and she always said
that... How is Miss Sally? I haven't seen her.
Passed away. About 2 years ago.
Oh, I didn't know.
Mm-hmm. And before she passed, she told me, Malin, you've been a real pillar to me. She gave that to me. Wanted me to have it.
Right.
Yes. I lived there with Miss Sally. She treated me with respect, she did. Of course, I was respectful to her right back. And kept a right nice house, too. Eat off the floors if you had a mind to. She kept it that clean, and we got along just fine, don't you know? Of course, folks talked all up and down the avenue, but we didn't pay him no mind.
Talk, Mr. Patterson?
We didn't pay him no mind at all. I want you to have my house when I die, she said. Then come to talk.
Mr. Patterson?
Yes, ma'am? I mean, how much will the rent be?
Oh, well, I was thinking about $40 a month, but you see, I really would...
Is that the kitchen right back there?
Yes, but I just wanted a lady.
Miss Frazier, you know you got a loose floorboard back here, and the one you got the rug over?
Mr. Patterson, I hope you won't be put off by what I'm going to say, but you see...
I won't take nothing but a hammer and a few nails, and I got both. As a matter of fact, I could even come back later on today.
Well, now, that's nice. I appreciate it.
I could wait until Saturday when I move in.
Saturday?
Mm-hmm. No reason for you to be tipping around here to keep from falling when I've got the tools and the time. Now, Saturday ain't too soon, is it now?
Well,
I could wait till Sunday. My room rent where I am is paid till Sunday.
Well, I guess Saturday would be all right, Mr. Patterson. The room's just about done up already, and, well, I guess Saturday would be just fine. I mean... Well, I had kind of thought you might want to see the room before you. Well, I just thought.
Ain't no need. I see what I see right here. Oh, I must say that I was taken aback a little bit. I'm in all these three-story buildings over there, and here you sit right squat to the ground. It's almost like you wanted to get just a little bit closer to the things of the world, don't you know? It's a nice place you've got here, Miss Frazier.
Well, there was a fire before we moved in, my husband and I. Wasn't nothing but 1.5 stories still standing. The city was going to tear down and start all over from the ground up. But Clarence, he said, I can take that place just like it is and make us a fine home. It may not look like them others they putting up, but I believe I can make us a place.
Everybody needs some place to be, I suppose.
Well, to be truthful, it did take some getting used to all the time looking up at the world.
Well, I got a lot of things to do, don't you know, packing and all, so I think I'll just leave you to yourself for a while.
Yes.
Yes. Oh, and about that floorboard, don't you worry nothing about it at all.
Well, yes, mister. Have a good day, mister. My goodness. Coming into people's houses, it ain't right. Brother Holloway, Mother Frazier. Oh, just fine, thank you. And you? Well, you have to take better care of yourself. Now, what I want to know is, when you going to fix that flowboat we've been talking about? Oh, of course I know that, Brother Holloway. Well, yes. Oh, I don't mean to be rushing you, but I don't want nobody tripping over that boat and taking me to court. Oh, fine. I'll be here. Oh, Brother Holloway, you there? Well, I want to thank you for speaking up for me. That gentleman you sent over, Mr. Patterson, well, I think you didn't. Malon. That's right, Malon Patterson. Well, I was sure he said that you... Well, could be I was mistaken. But I thought, sure, he said you told him.
I don't know when you're going to learn to lock that door. Things ain't like they used to be around here. Dope things running all up and down the avenue, knocking folks in the head. You can't trust nobody.
Oh, I forgot.
Yeah, I know. That woman that lives next door to that witch I go to on Thursday, she forgot. Left that door wide open. One of them junkies went in there and stole her jewelry, her money, and then he raped her. Yes, he did. Hmm. Of course, that last part, she ain't said nothing about that. But Thelma, the girl who works for her, she told me, just keep on leaving that door open. Now, you know that thing ain't never worked worth a tinker's damn. You need a TV?
Sarah.
Come on, get me a color TV when my ship comes in. throat's dry as dust. Need something to cut the phlegm.
I got a nice fresh pitcher of lemonade in the frigidaire.
Did you see that gentleman was over here a little while ago?
What gentleman? Ain't you got no more of that wine left that Dr. Simmons told you to take?
Well, you keep better track of that wine than I do. Said he wanted to rent my room, but I'd rather have...
Who? What room?
The gentleman.
You don't need no rumors. Besides, I ain't never known a rumor what wouldn't steal.
Well, he seemed right mannerly, he did. Said I still sent him.
Yeah, then I know he's sorry. What's his name?
Patterson. Malon Patterson. I ain't never known nobody named Malon before.
Now, you look here. I know that Malon Patterson. Don't you rent him nothing. You don't need no rumors. And especially none like that old scratcher. Did he try to sell you some cosmetics?
Well, no, he just...
Well, don't you be buying none. And do nothing but swell up your lips.
Well, he seemed like such a nice man.
How would you know? You don't do nothing but stay cooped up in this house.
Well, the room was just going to waste. Besides, it might be nice to have some company every now and then.
Oh, so I ain't no company no more. Well, I ain't come over here to stay anyway. I just came to get the key so I could pick up your check at the post office.
Same place it always is.
And this ain't the place to be keeping it, neither. Somebody come in here and steal it.
Now, who in the name of common sense would be looking for my postal box key? Honest to goodness, Sarah, sometimes I don't know how your mind works.
Well, if they'll steal your check out of the mailbox, you know they'll steal your key to get it. Lock the drawer.
Can a gentleman enter?
If you can find one, send him over.
Well, good gracious alive, I come over here to see one lady and the Lord bless me with two.
Come right on in, Brother Holloway. Don't pay Sarah no mind. I made you a pot of tea. I know you don't like nothing cold.
And that's another one you gotta watch. Middle of the summer, and he wants hot tea.
See, I likes my tea like I likes my women.
Oh, get off of my face, fool. And what in the name of sense made you tell that old Malon Patterson she had a room to rent?
Me? Well, I ain't tell him nothing. I ain't even seen him. Not for 3-4 years, ain't.
Who?
Oh, Sarah was just mentioning.
That old Malon Patterson told that lie.
He said you told him I was looking for a rumor.
Must have been my shadow. I don't know if I didn't recognize him anymore, been so long.
Well, now, why would he say something if it wasn't so? You didn't just forget now, did you, Estelle?
You don't forget a man like Malon Patterson. He'd steal an egg right out of the cake, he would.
Mr. Patterson.
The door was open. I knocked, but I guess you didn't hear me.
Sarah Williams, I'd like you to meet Mr. Malon Patterson.
I told you I knew him.
Well, I'll be doggone. And they say it's a small world.
Too small, if you ask me. Remember what I told you, you hear?
Sarah can be right funny acting sometime. I don't think she mean no harm. Won't you have a seat?
Well, actually, I brought my tools. I figured since I wasn't doing nothing, I might just as well fix that place back there in the kitchen.
Well, I'm mighty glad you did, but Brother Holloway was
Don't beat all. Should have known you'd be here. Any place you find a comely lady, you're bound to find old Estelle Holloway.
Well, seem to me you got that hind part forward. You the ladies, man.
Oh.
I want to take care of that. Old stick in the mud. Doggone if you don't look like $1 million.
How much I owe y'all still for fixing the boat?
Well, I guess that cup of tea just about covers it. Anyway, you the church mother, ain't you? Say a prayer for me. Yeah, last time I seen you was talking about leaving town.
When was that, Estelle? Just when did you see him last? I mean, y'all act like old friends.
Well, about 4 years ago, wasn't it? Right after Nancy died.
Just about.
I see.
Well, Guess I'll just go cross town.
Oh, don't let me chase you. I made a promise to Miss Lydia here and dropped by to make good on it.
Well, and I know you would, too. Now, Melvin Patterson's a man to keep his word, I can tell you that much. We was working as Pullman car porters, don't you know?
That long? You've been knowing each other that long.
Left home together.
We out there loading baggage. Bright Sunday day, middle of July. When, Lord have mercy, didn't we spot this fine, comely-looking thing cross on the other side, looking like a lost sheep if ever I saw one. Well, fool that I be, I pointed out to old Melvin here.
I won't like that, you know it. We both saw her.
No, 10-1, I have her cooking my dinner before you. That's what he said. Now, don't you know, I took him up on the bet before I could bat an eye the station master at the window. See, tapping for me to come into the office, I don't have to tell you where old Stick in the Mud went. Right smack over there to that fine young lady.
Hey, he won the bet. You too slow, Deacon Holloway.
Well, maybe so, Miss Fraser, but she just cooked my dinner. She married him.
Nancy?
Well, I wasn't going to mention that part.
Ah, still.
Fine man, that Brother Holloway.
Yeah.
A fine man. Such a willing worker. I had just called him to
Miss Fraser,
come over when he...
I said I'd fix that floorboard.
Oh, well, now, I couldn't expect you to do that.
I brought all my tools, and I went home just as fast as I could, got my hammer, picked up some nails on the way over here. You needn't call, Estelle. I said I'd do it.
Well, there's no need for you to carry on, Mr.
Patterson. There's plenty of reason for need. I mean, old folks, we gotta trust one another. I say I'm gonna do something, I mean to do it. Don't need no holy roller mouthful of honey, nigga, come doing for me.
Well, now, I ain't used to that kind of talking here, Mr. Patterson. Brother Holloway was simply doing me a favor, doing his Christian duty like he saw it. And I, Lord knows, I don't know why you carrying on like this.
Miss Frazier, I can't give you nothing except my word. Now, fixing this floorboard was something I could do for you, something I wanted to do for you because you're a nice lady and I appreciate what you're doing for me. Yes, I know I paid the rent and I'm going to continue to do that and right on time, but them few pennies ain't nothing compared to what you were offering to me, your home. And I hope your trust. Now, we don't need no Estelle Holloway come creeping around here doing for us. We can do for ourselves.
That's another thing, Mr. Patterson. I've given it some thought, and I don't think I'm quite ready for rumors just yet. I mean, the bed, it is too little for a man, and
well,
the
I've
room...
got this friend over on the avenue, deals in secondhand things, don't you know? Well, I probably could find me something that'll do me just fine. Probably even get a few pennies, but the one you got up there, I'm not a difficult man, Miss Fraser.
I don't want to rent the room. I mean, it's not that you're not a fine person and all, but... And if I was of a mind to rent it, well, I would really want somebody.
Now, there ain't no
like...
need for you to go on apologizing like that. I kind of expected you to slam the door in my face when I came in here this afternoon. I mean, that's the way it is with you church folks, ain't it? All the time got a mouthful of goodness for them what's dead and don't need nothing. But Lord have mercy, don't let a breathing living soul ask you for a doggone dime. You all turn tail every time. Run off someplace and pray to somebody else, anybody else. Come along and take care of them what you done turned down.
I'm sorry you feel that way. I didn't mean to...
Slap me in my face? You didn't want me to feel that I wasn't good enough to stay in the same house with you, ain't that right? You just want me to go quietly with a smile on my face. Well, you got what you wanted.
Mr. Patterson, the money. You forgot the money.
You know, it don't do to believe everything you hear, Miss Fraser.
I don't know what you mean.
Don't you think I don't know them two, what was just in here? Don't you think I don't know how they done poison your mind, telling you all kinds of lies and things?
Patterson. I ain't a worldly woman. Fact is, I ain't been out this city in more than 35 years. There's a whole lot of things I don't know about. Different kind of people I ain't never met. But there's one thing I do know about, and that's liars. Now, you call me a hypocrite. Well, I don't profess to have no wings, so I just might be what you say. But you come in here on a lie.
Of course I did.
Ostell ain't sent you here.
Woman, do you know what it is not to know where you're gonna lay your head from one day to the next? There ain't no rooms to be had out there. Not when you're old and by yourself. Folks don't want to be bothered. They're afraid they're gonna wake up some morning and find you laying up there dead or sick. Cause I lied. Fact is, I didn't even think you'd let me in that front door if I didn't send some old sad-ass deacon on in front.
You ain't got no place to stay?
Well, I'll be all right. Rooms don't cost but $3 a night.
I'll be just fine.
Well, now, it don't seem right that you should have to look for a place this late in the day. I did make you a promise. You can stay a week.
A week?
Well, that's if you found a place by then.
Oh, that should be plenty of time, Miss Frazier. I do want to thank you.
Well, I'm just doing my Christian duty, Mr. Patterson.
And what I said back there, I hope you know I was just talking off the top of my head. I mean, when you're angry, you say things that, well... You are a fine lady, Mrs. Frazier. You know, you and me... We're something that the rest of the world done left behind. So we got to do for ourselves. Truth to be told, when they come here to take you and me away, there ain't gonna be nothing but strangers holding onto that box.
Well, I guess I can be a bit more hospitable than at Father Divine's. Is something wrong?
No, I was just waiting. Figured maybe he was going to give me the rules.
Oh, yes.
You know,
yes.
Most folks, they give you the do's and don'ts right off.
Well, I mean to.
The decent hours.
That's right. And clean up after yourself in the kitchen.
Yes, ma'am.
And I'd appreciate it if you put the trash out every Tuesdays and Thursdays. That is, if you don't mind.
Mind, Miss Frazier, I'll put them out on Wednesdays and Fridays, too, if I have to.
It's the first door on the left.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Mr. Patterson.
Yes, ma'am.
They don't pick up trash only on Tuesdays and Thursdays.
Well, you can ignore me if you want, but I'm telling you the truth. Men like Malin Patterson don't do nothing but prey on old women. Move in with them and take them for everything they got. Sally Hempstead, you remember her? Lonzie left her well off. And when she died, they put her in a pauper's grave.
Well, I may not be worldly, but I ain't foolish.
Malin lived with her. You ask him if you think I'm lying. He'd get his check and give it all to them chippies. What for? I don't even want to put my mind to it. Because he certainly was too old to play a man's part.
Oh, Sarah.
Of course, you might know something that I don't. After all, it ain't my house he's living in.
It's enough of that talk, too. The things you say.
Well, ain't nothing what ain't the gospel truth. You think I wouldn't like to have a man around that old shack of mine? Folks think when you get old, you're supposed to dry up. Lose all your feelings. Supposed to be content to be by yourself. Well, I ain't. No. Sometimes I feel like I could grab one of them old deacons out of that church and lock him up in the house forever. So that's why I know you let this man come into your life, Lidia. Ain't we getting along? Don't I take care of you? You're the mother of the church. We always get along, don't we, Lidia?
Oh, Sarah, my taking in a rumor don't mean I'm gonna close my door to my friends. You're welcome here anytime you choose to come.
It's a good thing the Lord sends down somebody to take care of fools. Get the check ready. I'll take it to the bank. That man made me so mad yesterday, I've almost forgot it.
You didn't take it with you?
Ain't that what I just finished telling you? I went down to the bank, and Miss Johnson was waiting for me at the window. And she said, You mean to tell me you with that man in this house, you left that check laying out here?
Well, if you didn't take it, it should be right there.
Man ain't been in this house 24 hours, and already your stuff started to take feet.
Now, I left that envelope right here on this table. I know I did.
I remember, because he was standing right there holding that old beat-up bag.
Now, you don't know for sure Mr. Patterson took it. It don't do to be running people down like that.
Well, I still didn't take it, and I sure hope to God you don't think that I did.
Oh, I ain't thinking nothing. And what's more, I ain't gonna think about it until I get a chance to talk to that man.
Oh, yes. And he's just gonna come out and say, "Well, yes, ma'am, Miss Lydia, I took your check, but I didn't think you would mind living in this fine house and all." Oh, Lydia, don't be no fool. Put that nigga in the street.
It's a mighty fine day out there today, Miss Lydia. Don't see how y'all can stay in here all day with the shades all drawn. Need to let some sun shine in.
Well, where'd you get that?
I don't see as how that's any of your business.
It'll be my business when the cops come rolling around.
Sarah.
Lydia, you don't know this man like I do.
I don't expect there's anybody in this town who knows me like you do, Sarah Williams. But I paid for this.
With what? You ain't never had two nickels to rub against another.
That'll be enough.
Now, we can leave it right here. That way we both can look at it.
Most shows come in color. Remember about that thing.
Oh, I just don't know what gets into Sarah sometimes.
Nothing but the devil, if you ask me.
Well, she had no call to. I mean, I just don't understand it when she gets in her moods like this.
I ain't steal nothing.
I never thought you did. I never thought you would.
Well, it ain't quite all paid for altogether. What I mean to say is I just paid half. No, I saw how you didn't have no entertainment. And believe you me, I know how lonely it can be with nobody in the house and nothing to stir up the quiet. So I have this friend over on the avenue. Deals in secondhand things, kind of, don't you know? Well, most of them work quite good, only they're a little bit used, you understand? So today I seen this setting right up there in the corner, and I thought maybe you might...
Oh, Mr. Patterson, I appreciate that, but I couldn't let you. I mean, that's a goodly piece of money, secondhand or no.
Well, I only had $20. I mean, after paying my rent and all, so I just thought that, well, maybe what with my check and your check put together, we might both could spare enough to...
My check, Mr. Patterson?
Well, your part is only half, only $20. And he said he'd wait for that. And of course, when I go, it'll still be yours.
Oh, well, I hadn't planned on spending no extra money this week, and I wouldn't feel right keeping the whole thing, and...
My part is your birthday present.
My present? How did you know?
The church program. I saw it here today. Here it is, says here, birthdays of the month, Mrs. Lydia Frazier, the church mother.
Now, I just don't see as how I can give back such a fine present now, can I?
Miss Lydia, I didn't mean no harm.
Oh, I fixed you something to eat.
I'll sit when you do.
Oh. May I just take off my apron for this special occasion, you know?
Here you go.
Oh, thank you, thank you. You may bless the table, Mr. Patterson.
Bless what? Oh, yeah. Dear Lord, bless this food and the good feelings that, amen.
Jesus wept. They used to give me a bouquet for my birthday every year down at the church.
Oh?
I guess they just forgot last year.
Well, my birthday in March. And most of the times I have me a birthday party every year. Of course, most of the times I'm pretty by myself, too, but I have myself a ball just the same.
I never had a party. Not no real one, I mean. Not even when I was young. My father, he didn't believe in Christian folks raising all that sin, acting a fool, he called it. You go to church, Mr. Patterson?
Well, not no more, I don't. I did down home. I even did a little preaching every now and then. But I come up here and it won't the same.
Now, I don't mean no harm, but Jesus, he don't... You may bless the table, Mr. Patterson.
Bless what? Oh, yeah. Dear Lord, bless this food and the good feelings that, I mean, amen.
Jesus wept. They used to give me a bouquet for my birthday every year down at the church.
Oh?
I guess they just forgot last year.
Well, my birthday in March. And most of the times I have me a birthday party every year. Of course, most of the times I'm pretty by myself, too, but I have myself a ball just the same.
I never had a party. Not no real one, I mean. Not even when I was young. My father, he didn't believe in Christian folks raising all that sin, acting a fool, he called it. You go to church, Mr. Patterson?
Well, not no more, I don't. I did down home. I even did a little preaching every now and then. But I come up here and it won't the same.
Now, I don't mean no harm. But Jesus, he don't know nothing about territories. He's the same anywhere you go.
Maybe so, but people ain't. Oh, you know that old record player in the other room? I think I got it working. Oh. Be nice to put on some music to go with this fine repast.
That old thing? Mm-hmm. It haven't worked in 30 years. We used to use it to play the hymns on when we couldn't get out to the services, don't you know?
Well, I used to be quite a dancer in my day.
Mr. Patterson, there was a letter
love
on the
to
table.
Dance.
I hope you won't mind my question, but...
Miss Frazier, I'd be mighty pleased if you'd favor me with this dance.
I don't even know how to dance, Mr. Patterson.
Come on.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my. What a surprise. Well, I just don't know. I'm no good at it, you know. My goodness.
Oh, Miss Frazier. You hadn't ought to let your check be out here where just any old body can pick it up. I saw it laying there this morning, so I moved it.
Oh, thank you. I'm very careless.
Oh.
Sarah always said that I was.
You're a fine dancer, Miss Frazier. And I ought to know, because I done twirled the best of them. Yes. Light on your feet, y'all. And a good cook.
Oh, my goodness. So many compliments. It's been 50 years. 50 years since I danced. And oh, how I used to love it. My daddy and then my husband, don't you know, they was both deacons of the church. And not even on my wedding night, not even then did I dance. All the time they say, don't nothing but fast women want to be shaking themselves like that. And I'd nod and say yes. But Lord, when I'd hear the music, my soul would be just a-jumping and a- dancing. I was saved and holy. But in the inside, my heart was such a dancer. Oh.
You know, Miss Fraser, I wouldn't take nothing from you.
Oh.
Now, that check was just laying there, and fact is, I was going to draw it to your attention that you hadn't cashed it. Wanted to know if you wanted me to take it with me downtown when I went to cash mine.
Well,
I don't mind the trip. All you got to do is sign it.
Sarah, she usually does that, you know, and... Mm-hmm.
Would you? It would save me from going out in all that traffic. I generally deposit $100, and then I keep the rest for church and for food.
We're gonna be fine. Me and you? We're gonna be just fine.
Him
this thing
over there. Well, I ain't got no light. You the one that likes to burn them 100-watt bulbs of electricity. Stand over there so I can hem this in.
It's kind of fancy, but nice. I wish I had the nerve to wear something like this. Kind of puts me in mind the dress I've married in. Same color.
I got married in purple. Didn't have nothing else. Because given what I got, it should have been black. Stand still!
Oh, stop it.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Miss Lidia. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, Miss Lidia. Happy birthday to you.
Oh,
it's only 7 candles. Must have been counting by 10.
I didn't have no time to get you a proper present. I hope you won't mind.
Won't mind? Oh, Deacon Holloway, I'm just so pleased that y'all remembered. I'm so pleased. You are only as old as you feel. Now, I know that to be so, because I feel every day. Oh, now you know you shouldn't have done nothing like this.
See, I wanted to give you a dollar for every year, but I kind of quit when I thought it was polite.
You quit because your pocket run dry, you old liar.
you got to get a mirror so you can see my present. Papa-like.
A mirror? Mm-hmm. Now, what kind of foolishness you got up your sleeve, Mr. Patterson?
Ain't no foolishness. Tell us, Sarah.
No, that dress. I went down to the store, but Malin picked it out.
Oh, I can't accept this. I mean, you done already give me the TV. Well, it wouldn't be right.
TV? The dress?
Well, I
and paid, money?
I paid half for the TV, but... He give me the other half as a present, and now I'm going to take this lovely dress up and take it off, and you can take it back and get your
now,
money.
Now, it ain't right to take back things folks give you, Miss Lydia. My pleasure's in the giving.
Oh, it's a lovely dress, and I do thank you.
Well, TV and the dress and money, did it? Well, this is little old something. You can use it if you want to.
Whatever it is, I know it's fine. Fine, because you give it to Miss Sarah Williams. So there. Oh, they so soft and nice. I do thank you, Sarah.
Just something for your hands.
Well, now, if I can get me some help in the kitchen, we can get this party started and have us a little something to eat.
I ain't come over here to work. Ain't nothing to do but cut the cake.
Not when Mail and Patterson throws a party. We're going to dine in style.
Oh, did you cook the food, Mr. Patterson?
Oh, stick in the mud. Here was the head cook at the Delphi Hotel.
Now, what you want to tell that lie for, man?
Well, you might as well have been the chef and did more cooking than he did.
Well, come on, Lydia. I don't like men in the kitchen. It ain't clean. Come on.
Whoa. Don't pay Sarah no mind. Oh,
yeah. I never thought I'd see you again.
Yeah, I figured somebody'd be done kill me by now, huh?
No, I ain't say that.
Not with your lips, you didn't.
He must have been quite a figure in them days.
Elon Patterson was worth the trouble then, but now...
Now, just what were you gentlemen talking about when we were back there?
Up to devil, man.
No, what kind of devil, man? We were just talking about that time when we was working at the Delphi Hotel. See, we didn't have money to pay rent and eat both. So, old Mailer here had took to snitching a roll off them platters we delivered to the hotel guest room.
Yeah, you see, one day I was taking this roast beef dinner up to this man who used to own racehorses.
Yeah, he always wore these shiny black boots, he did.
Well, I lifted the lid off the platter like I usually did, but Lord have mercy, that gravy looked so good, I thought I just would slide that roll around in that gravy. Then I'd shake the platter, don't you know, so I'd cover up them tracks. Well, Lord have mercy, I got a bed at the door and to start on in, and then I get my tip and I start on out. Well, if that man didn't pick up that lid and see them tracks in that gravy, come here, boy. He say right nasty like, somebody been sopping in my gravy.
Next thing I know, they throwing old Mailin' out the street.
Get him into almost. But you know what I did? I set myself up a shoeshine stand across the street in the lobby of the Carter Arms. Mm-hmm. Now guess who came jumping off my stand? Not 3 weeks later.
He was doing good with that shoeshine stand, too. Brought home more than I did.
The man with the boots come looking down at me.
He recognized you?
Say, ain't you that boy that used to work across the street? I said to him, yeah, I'm the one, but I'm sopping in my own gravy now. So I never worked for another crack as long as I live.
And he never did either. Worked for himself from that
Keep
day
your
on.
Keep fingers out of that chicken. The plate's over there.
Would you like me to fix a plate for you, Mr. Patterson?
I would appreciate it if you would. And while you're doing that, I think I'm just going to make a quick run here into the kitchen and get the piece de resistance.
Well, ain't you going to eat nothing, Sister Williams?
I might try a little bit later on. You tell me how it is.
Ooh! Old cracker's alive. Pull down the shade. Turn out the light. Old folks going to cut a rug tonight.
Birthday ain't but one day a year.
Two bottles. Don't you think that's a bit too much?
Not if you're used to drinking four.
Oh, now, Sarah, a little wine ain't gonna hurt. Especially since it's kind of like a holiday.
Shoot, four. I could drink that many when I was 14.
I bet you could.
Well, now, I'm sure the Lord won't frown on us if we have just a little drop with our dinner.
Well, he ain't never frowned on that peach wine Sister Sarah be sipping every afternoon she come over here.
Now, you can do what you wanna. But don't pour me none. I ain't gonna be bringing the habits of the street into a Christian home. And my peach wine is my business.
Now, just a minute now. Ain't nobody disrespecting nobody.
Amen. Even Jesus Christ was known to take a little taste every now and then.
Will you hush your hypocritical mouth?
Now, Sarah, please, don't. I'm sure that we're gonna toast my birthday and eat our dinner, and then we'll settle the accounts with the Lord at prayer meeting.
Well, you can do what you want, but I don't think all of us are going to prayer meeting.
And while we're dining, I got a little announcement to make.
What announcement you got to make?
We're going into business, that's what.
What we?
Miss Frazier and me.
You lie. Oh, stay away from y'all two, three, the whole world done turned bottom sides off. Just what kind of business you thinking of?
We gonna put our little resources together and open us a candy store right here in this living room.
Now, I know you done lost your mind.
This is mighty fine vintage. Ooh. Tastes just like Samoa.
Clarence would stand up in his grave, merchandising in his living room.
Well, sound like a good idea to me. Colored folks got to be more enterprising.
When you be more enterprising, you spend your own money. And I know Lydia ain't let this fool
talk her into spending her hard-earned cash for no candy store.
Yeah, but I would be a partner. 50-50 now, wouldn't I?
The hell you would.
I don't mean any harm, Mrs. Williams, but I think you're kind of stepping out of your place, don't you think? I mean, if Miss Lydia and me done made an agreement.
Agreement, my foot. But you know I'm right, Lydia. This old Maline Patterson done come in here and filled your head with a whole lot of simple-minded schemes.
Being independent is simple-minded, huh?
Taking other people's money is. Especially when they're old and they don't, there ain't no time to be starting nothing.
Oh. Now, wait.
Now, Sarah ain't all wrong, Miss Lydia. You want to watch your money. State ain't gonna give you enough to live on no way, but at least it's regular.
Happy birthday, Miss Lydia. Now, we ain't gonna talk about it no more today. This is a party. Time for celebration.
Oh, the hell we are. We're gonna bury it right now, Maylin Patterson. You wanna, I told this woman that she didn't need you here anyway. You wanna open up a candy store? Use your own money. You ought to be ashamed of yourself trying to come in here to take this woman and jip her out of her money. Nigga, you ought to get on your knees and pray.
I'm gonna slap you across your mouth.
Now, Sarah ain't all wrong, Miss Lydia. You want to watch your money. State ain't gonna give you enough to live on no way, but at least it's regular.
Happy birthday, Miss Lydia. Now, we ain't gonna talk about it no more today. This is a party. Time for celebration.
Oh, the hell we are. We're gonna bury it right now, Maylin Patterson. You wanna, I told this woman that she didn't need you here anyway. You wanna open up a candy store? Use your own money. You ought to be ashamed of yourself trying to come in here to take this woman and jip her out of her money. Nigga, you ought to get on your knees and pray.
I'm going to slap you across your mouth. That's what I ought to do. But I'm just going to ask you to leave this house. You ain't welcome in here no more.
Well, now, let's not be hasty, Mr. Patterson. I'm sure Sarah didn't mean
to. Don't you be apologizing for me. He ain't nothing but a rumor. You ain't got no right to tell me when to go and to come in this house.
Oh, you got some special rights over here now, huh?
Yes. I'm her friend. What are you? Clarence asked me to look after this woman.
Well, nobody don't care about no promises made to the dead. I'm the man in this house.
Mr. Patterson.
And I don't want you coming around here causing no more confusion.
Now, Mayor, I don't think you should say...
It's a little bit late for you to start talking about Stell. Yeah, years too late. Now, I hate to spoil the party, but I think Miss Lydia and me can pick it up when the atmosphere's a little bit more to our liking.
Lydia, ain't you gonna say something?
Now, I just ain't used to all this wrangling and fussing.
Maylin, we're poor folks. And sometimes poor folks have to do terrible things to put food on their table and clothes on their back. But this is ugly, man, ugly. And you know, you're gonna pay for this. You're gonna pay for this. Your black behind is going to be right back there in Father Divine's where you come from. And I'm going to see to that. Come on, Estelle.
Miss Lydia, what you doing? Now, don't do that. This is your birthday. Now, there ain't no cause to... No, wait.
I didn't say nothing in there, Mr. Patterson, because I ain't used to all this fussing and wrangling in my house.
Now, I tried to keep cool, but she...
They are my friends. The only friends I got left in this world.
Then I feel sorry for you, because ain't no way in hell I'm going to claim those churchified wrecks as being friends of mine.
Well, who do you claim, Mr. Patterson? Because ain't no man living what can live by himself.
Now, that's what you're counting on? Well, let me tell you something, Miss Frazier, because somebody need to tell you, ain't nothing to them. The both of them put together ain't nothing you can depend on. You good for them. What you call necessary. They can feel big, good, and Christian, coming around here making you feel old and helpless. Them's your friends.
I don't want to hear no more. You can pack up your things and get out of here before the weekend.
Uh-uh. I ain't going nowhere.
I said you can...
I heard what you said, but I ain't going nowhere. This is my home. And I ain't going back in that street no more. Now, goddammit, woman, I ain't never had nothing. Ain't nobody ever treated me like I was human until I walked into this house. And I'm not leaving.
Just like he was. Just raising sand all the time. Just... I can't let you stay here. You just like him. And I asked God to move him out of my life just to give me a little peace.
Miss Lydia, please. Now, don't want no police cars coming up here.
This is my house.
Yes, ma'am. And I'm going to respect that. But you don't understand. There's more to it. There's more to it.
I just want you to go.
Now let me speak. And then maybe you'll see why you're throwing me out in the street. Why they're so hot to have me scrounging around in the gutter like some mangy old dog. You don't know him, Miss Frazier. You don't know him, and I do. They're scared. Scared I'm going to throw up in the windows and let the light come so you'll see them for what they were, what they are. Yes, I ain't no angel. Ain't never tried to be one. I ain't never tried to hide my dirt beneath a blanket full of mealy-mouthed prayers and him singing neither. Shoot, Malin Patterson was a pretty nigga. And everybody said how bad I was. Lived too much in the fast life, don't you know? Well, I kept me a pocket full of money all the time. Changed my clothes 2-3 times a day, yes. And drove a black Buick all the time, a Buick. And I didn't steal none of it.
I never thought you'd take a dime. I just don't think you believe.
Oh, yeah, I played the horses, ran my own lottery, and yeah, maybe I did boost a little every now and then, but I didn't steal. And I didn't hurt nobody. I wasn't gonna waste the best years of my life working in some factory lifting garbage and saying yes to some white man just to keep some old bitties from talking about me. Hey, and women, yes, ma'am, I had me some women, pretty. Fine women, full of life, tied down to some sad-ass church boy who didn't have nothing to give them unless it was a baby once a year, and I took their money. I made them forget those ass-dragging men they was married to.
Sarah Williams.
And God rest her soul. Nancy Holloway.
Oh, no. And Estelle, did he know?
Of course he knew. Somehow you always know. But you know something? I wanted to tell him, face to face. Wanted him to know what a fine woman he had, because she was. And being with Nancy, well, won't like the others.
But he was your friend.
That's why I wanted to tell him he was my friend. Only one I had in the world. Something was happening to me. And I wanted to share. Now, I wouldn't have never taken it away from him. I would have stopped it before it got that far. Yeah, one day I made my mind I was going to let him know. Because he was my friend. And I just wanted to keep things between us honest, open. So I call him up. He come over, like he always did, right after work. We was drinking a couple of beers, and I started talking about this and that, don't you know, working up to what I wanted to say, and all of a sudden, I can see from the way he won't hardly looking at me that he already knew. So I grabbed him, I turned him around. There he was, eye to eye, toe to toe. Man, do you know who I'm talking about? I done got religion, Malin. The Lord done come into my life, and I'm a new man. Shoot! A new man! Well, we never talked again after that. And Nancy, well, she started feeling ashamed, and, well, it wasn't the same no more. Wasn't my fault if he had what I wanted. And I'd be damned if I was gonna feel all guilty. I didn't even go to her funeral.
And Sarah, did you love her too?
Love her? Sarah Williams?
Excuse me for saying this, but that's the evilest half I ever saw. Spill a pot of grease on me once. Because I wouldn't take her to Atlantic City. Yeah, still got the scars all up down my back now, and I know her husband knew. He was just glad to get rid of that old bird.
Mr. Patterson, you ought to stop.
Yeah, but he did. I swear to God her husband knew. Yeah, he probably just wanted somebody to get that old biddy out in his hair every once in a while, but... You know something? That's about the only woman who ever kept me halfway straight. I mean as she was. I wasn't about to be playing around too much, especially after that grease. Oh, no.
And Sister Sarah never had but one man, and that one was her husband. I've been knowing her for nigh on to 20 years.
Do she got a mole on her right thigh, about 4 inches above the knee? Oh, Miss Lennon, I need to pick out a turn. I know they're your friends, and I ain't in the custom of talking against
folks. You don't know how good
friends.
You made me feel. I have laughed like that, and, oh, and I'm glad. I'm glad, Sarah. You as quiet as kept. I always thought she had a man. Lord knows, but that when she was married to, she sure needed somebody. You know, I'm the only friend she's got left. All the other old timers, and she likes to make a fuss over me.
But you know something, Miss Lydia, you shouldn't be afraid of gossiping or saying anything like that that you think might be bad. Not if it's the truth. Ain't nothing wrong with saying what's true. And that's true. That man of hers look right much like a frog. Them bow legs and poppy eyes. Oh, Miss Lydia. Yeah. Tell me something. I mean, did you ever? Now, what I mean to say is, did you,
No, Mr. Patterson, but I ain't gonna say I never thought about it. It was this young man what used to work in the drugstore that was down there near the church. Mm-hmm. You know, we used to have a fine drugstore down there on the corner.
Yes, I remember.
Well, Harry Edwards was his name. And every Sunday, I'd find some reason to go in there. I think he knew, because he always give me something extra, something a little special. One Sunday, I looked up, and he was joining the church. Lord, all the sisters started getting happy, waiting around to give him the right hand of fellowship. But I wouldn't. Every time the feeling would come over me, I would clench my teeth and ball my fist. Clarence, he put his arm around me, but I didn't even feel him. I just wanted to jump up and holler. But it wasn't the Holy Ghost, and I knew it. I wouldn't even give him the right hand of fellowship. Went down the back way. I was scared he'd see them carnal thoughts in my eyes. Oh, Mr. Patterson, I ain't never told that to nobody.
You still ain't.
He had the prettiest eyes. Oh. Lord, just look at me right for the devil.
Now, ain't that what being young's all about, fighting with the devil in us? time you get old, you either call a truce or win the battle.
You sure have lived a life, haven't you?
I sure have. Yes, ma'am. Ain't got no apologies. What I said about me not going, I take that all back. If you want.
Mr. Patterson, you think we ought to have something in that store besides candy? I mean, we could have soap powders and some of the things the ladies need, and we haven't cut the cake. I'll get a knife, and we can cut the cake, and then maybe have just a little spot of that fine wine, and then we can talk about the candy store.
Yes, ma'am. Sounds fine. Don't look secondhand to it.
Secondhand? It looks just fine.
Well, I got this fellow over on the avenue, don't you know? And it ain't exactly new, but I have to do a little business today with folks who are accustomed to doing business, so I thought I better get me some good-looking clothes.
Well, you look just fine, just like a preacher.
A what?
Fine. You look just fine. I know it's gonna be hard for me to shine next to such a bright-looking gentleman. But I think my new frock will serve the occasion, thank you.
How much we got?
Well, I went down to the bank and drew out my share today. Lord, how money can add up. I didn't know I had that much in there. Well, I counted. And altogether, we got a little more than $600.
That much? Crackers a lot. That's all right. That'll get us a license and a little bit to put on the merchandise. You know, I phoned the insurance man, and I've got to stop by there this afternoon when I'm downtown. Did you do yours?
Well, I don't feel so good about turning in my insurance.
Well, you're not turning in your insurance. You're just borrowing on it. I mean, those folks ain't going to loan us no money less than they see where we've just done made a move on our own.
I know, but you need insurance.
Well, what for? You the church mother. They ain't going to hardly put you in no box on Potter's Field. It'd be too embarrassing. Anyway, you dead then. It don't make no difference. Truth be told, you done paid those white folks three times what it's worth anyway. That's the way they do colored people.
Well, I know, but
suit yourself. Don't make me know another man. We got enough to open the stove.
Well, I want to do my part.
Where's the envelope?
It's in the bureau.
Oh, well, I'm just going to take just enough to pay the license. I'll take the rest with me when I go downtown later.
You need me to go with you?
Not this time.
There you go, and look like a Mississippi gambler.
Don't he look nice?
I told you what I thought he looked like.
Well, I ain't gonna pay her no mind. This suit is a Botany 500.
Yeah, well, it may be a Botany 500, but it sure is the body is like Robert Hall to me. Oh, Lord, I may have to cut that Wednesday woman loose. Every bone in my body is screaming. You don't have to hide nothing from me. You ain't got nothing I want. So, you're going through with it, huh?
I told you so yesterday.
Well, sometimes when folks sleep on a thing, they come to their senses.
You have to excuse the mess.
I did already. These burning feet of mine, they made me do it.
I left
that up on your bureau. You can put it with the rest later.
Oh, well, it's in the pillowcase. You can put it there if you want.
No, you take care of it, but I'll ask you for it when I need it.
All right.
Afternoon, Miss Sarah.
Sarah.
Hot as it was, she wanted me to wash them steps.
You didn't have to call Otis.
Yes, I did. You telling me to bring them insurance policies over here so you could sign them over to that mailing fool. I had to call somebody.
I ain't signing nothing over to nobody.
Well, it don't make no sense to me.
It ain't your business.
It is my business when my best friend starts to act like a child.
All I want you to do is bring me my papers over here.
I'm gonna give them to Otis when he comes.
Otis ain't coming. I told him to stay up there and mind his own business. Anyway, them papers is mine. I just give them to you to hold.
You ain't give me nothing. Clarence give them to me. And don't think I don't know you didn't go down to the bank and draw all that money out of there either. Lydia, if I didn't know better, I'd think that man had you fixed or put a spell on you. Because ain't no woman in her right mind.
If you won't give me what's mine, I swear I'll go across the street and go through every drawer in that house until I find them. Now, we making a payment on the showcases today, and we seeing the distributor in the morning. And I don't intend to come up short on my part. Sarah, pay attention to me. Them papers is mine.
I ain't said they wasn't. But Clarence give them to me.
Clarence is dead. He's dead. And them little old bit of policies is mine to live with. And I ain't thinking about dying right now. Just bring me my papers, please. I done already called Mr. Pierce.
Lord, Lydia, ain't gonna nothing gonna help you but prayer. The Lord bless you to live a full life. And what you do? You turn your back on all them that loves you. Turn your back and take up with a dreamer.
Love me. You mean them folks down at the church? They don't love me. I'm just some freak of nature. Something that's done live way past his time. Somebody to give testimonials for. Take up a special collection for on homecoming day. All them things make them feel Christian. And if you so moved to pray, Sarah, you better pray for yourself, because you ain't so covered up as you think.
Covered up?
Lord, have mercy.
Oh, Lord, Lydia, that man done told you that I was out to hurt him, that I wanted to do something to him for something that's dead and gone. Oh, Lord. Look at me, honey. What would I even think of and look like thinking about all that old mess 20 years ago? A little bit of old sneaking around every now and then just so I could feel like somebody. I thought you knew me better than that. Once a long time ago, well, mailing might have been something, but now...
Please, give me my papers.
I got them. I had them all along. I just wanted to have my say. You never even asked me. I waited. You never even said a mumbling word. I could have helped in that store. You always ask me things, even when Clarence was alive. It makes a difference when you got somebody to do for.
Oh,
but
Sarah.
That Malin Patterson is come hopscotching around here and you forget. And you let him put me out like a stranger. Oh. What in the sense is that?
Yeah, pick this up over on Master Street.
What is that, Brother Holloway?
Well, I thought y'all might could use this in the store.
That's a meat scale. We ain't selling no meat.
And you can't weigh candy on the meat scale, I suppose.
Oh, well, now, I'm sure we can use that.
Where'd you get it?
Well, over at the supermarket over there on Master Street. See, I goes over there every Wednesday to pick up the old boxes and things. Uh-huh. And this was just sitting out there. So I just figured...
Oh, Mr. Patterson will be overjoyed.
Well, I hope the Board of Health don't see it. Well, I gotta go home.
Well, watch out across the street, Austin.
Ain't nobody gonna bother that old bird. She can take care of herself by 3-4 others at the same time. Oh, I sure am glad for you, Miss Lydia. I swear to God I am. No, there's a lot of talk around town, but oh, I'll have to tell you that.
Talk?
Oh, you know what I mean about how Malin leading you up a blind alley. Oh, some folks say he don't intend to stay here. Don't just take what you got.
What do you think this little hole here on the side is for?
Oh, oil. That's where you put the oil. Hey, everybody talking, but the most I'm wishing you well.
Glad to hear that. That they wish me well.
Hey, you know what else I heard?
Other folks talk don't interest me.
Yeah, but this will kill you.
Well, most gossip will if you think about it long enough.
Yeah, amen. But you know that old lady with the limp? One used to live over there on Newkirk Street. Well, I heard her talking about how a certain church mother done took herself a lover. Well, that's what she said.
I like that. It ain't true, but I like that. It's done took me all this long to get them old biddies to waggling about me. And Miss Lydia done got herself a lover. Yeah, I like that. But when they say lover, they mean something different from a companion, don't they? I know they do. But you know something? I don't really care. Fact is, I almost wish it was true.
Ooh, now, Mother Frazier.
Oh, I don't mean Mr. Patterson particularly. I just mean it might be nice to have somebody just think about you like that. I don't think Clarence ever thought me back. I was a lover. I was his wife. You understand what I mean? Did you ever think about Nancy like that? Like she was your lover?
Think about Nancy?
Oh, for real, Austell. I need to know. Wife and widow, that's the only woman in this I know. And just when I'm getting to the end of it all, I seem to realize how much more there could have been. I never was a mother.
Nancy, my lover. Well, she was the only woman ever... the only woman I ever knew, so I reckon you would say she was everything a woman's supposed to be.
You mean you never had another woman?
Me? No, never wanted another. Of course, there was a time when I thought she had, but nothing ever come of it. If she had somebody, nothing come of it. That was a long time ago, all that heat and fire, you know. Lived together long enough, it's long gone, but... why the devil you want to bring up something like that?
Well, 'cause if folks saying I got a lover, I think I ought to know what it is I'm supposed to have. You know, Austell, it ain't fair for folks to grow old unless they've been young.
Well, you ain't old, Mother Frazier. You ain't old at all.
Lord, when I lay in my bed and listen to my insides mumbling and grumbling so loud it keeps me awake. And when everybody all the time telling you how much they love you, and don't nobody, no time, no way ever dislike nothing you ever do, you old Brother Holloway. I just might take myself a sweetheart and walk down the streets holding his hand in the broad daylight. Lord have mercy, a lover. Most of us ain't got nothing to talk about.
Well, what's the matter? You all look like you done seen a ghost.
Come in so quiet.
Now, what's this, huh?
Well, I don't know that they done changed them up too much lately, but last time I asked, they were still calling them scales.
I still thought... We might could use it. I told him you'd be surprised.
Take it on back where you got it.
Well, I don't
think... We don't need it.
Don't look like too much is wrong with it.
Want some of this Deacon Holloway?
No. I mean, just because I let myself go the other day.
Oh, I know about that. I just asked you if you wanted to join me in a little drink. I mean, it ain't always what we should do that we want to do, and I just thought this might be one of them times.
They didn't hold back the showcases like you asked them to, did they?
One of them times when you decided to put should out to pasture and concentrate on what you want to do. Does you good to do that every now and then.
You didn't answer my question.
Yeah, he kept the showcases. I don't know why you think he shouldn't. Ah, well, Ostell, y'all know about co-signing. Y'all know what that is?
Co-signing?
That's when the man promises to respect you as a man so long as he can find somebody else who knows you a man also.
You didn't even see that man with the showcases, did you?
No, Miss Lydia, I didn't. Didn't see no need to. Ain't gonna be no candy store unless I can work out something real quick. Where I went was back to the Senior Citizens Council. The bus stopped right dead in front of their offices. So I didn't see no reason why I should just run on in there and say hello to them fine people who were so nice to us on the telephone. See if I couldn't find that fine young man who come out here with all them papers for us to sign. All that talk about our golden ages should not be afraid of enterprises. I just thought I'd say these golden ages were enterprising as hell on a hot day in June. Yes, sir. Say, what do you do, Ostell? I mean, you don't drink with your friends no more. And it don't take much to see that your baby-making days is long gone, yeah. Yeah, what do the good church people do when they ain't singing, praying, or stuffing their mouths with some the sister's chicken dinner?
You want me to drink with you, Mel? You need somebody to drink with?
No, I don't particularly think I need that. I'm just trying to be polite. I mean, when you got to say ugly things, sometimes it's better to be polite. I'm just pouring a little molasses on the pile, don't you know?
Ain't gonna be no store.
I'm sorry.
Where you going, Ostell?
Get me a glass.
Well, it's all right. I mean, we got our health and strength, and if we don't get the store now,
you know,
well,
I'm glad you said that, because that's what's been worrying me. Yeah, I was worried how you'd feel when I came home and told you we had to have us a co-signer. Was worried about that all the way home. Yeah, here I thought I was going to get out of this respectable, independent, useful. Yeah, shoot. I was even thinking I was going to take a shot at John and Ebenezer.
Maybe my nephew would.
He don't live in the state. And it got to be somebody what own a house. Got all their limbs in working condition. Somebody to guarantee. You understand? Living. Yeah, that's what they want. Somebody to make some other folks want to live long enough to pay off a loan.
Well, why don't you say so? I got me a house.
Now, Ostell.
I do.
I can't let you do nothing like that.
Now, why not? Y'all can't be wanting that much money. And anyway.
Anyway, nothing. Now, you done worked too hard for that house to have it be given over to some white folks downtown.
He ain't giving nothing to nobody. He's just putting his name on a piece of paper and promising to pay some money. And anyway, them loans is insured. Mm-hmm. Ain't nobody, be nobody coming after him.
That's right. You know, Amos Jackson co-signed for me when I got my first car. Now, how long y'all need it for?
It's a 3-year loan. But we're going to make all them payments. You hear me? As a matter of fact, we done put a little bit down already in advance, so you ain't got to worry about a thing, man.
Oh, now, Mr. Patterson, you just can't let the man...
But let the man what? Let the man do what? All we want is his signature, and he don't have to give us that if he don't want to. But I tell you one thing, we got to be down there tomorrow afternoon with them papers and a co-signer. Well, it ain't no business. There ain't no two ways of that.
Well, it ain't right to make somebody else carry your weight. It ain't right, and I don't want nothing to do with it.
But it's just like he said, only a signature.
I don't want no co-signers. I ain't going away from here owing nothing to nobody, not even them white folks downtown.
What'd you expect to do, sell chicken dinners, run a couple of buses to Atlantic City?
It's better than borrowing.
Damn you, old woman, who the hell cares about what you owe after you dead? I seen this store going down the drain this afternoon. It wasn't because I couldn't get the money up. Hell, a few $100 mailing Patterson pissed that much away any night in the week if it wanna. It's just because I couldn't find any way to get the money that would please satisfy you. That's the truth.
No way that was decent. Kind. Christian. Now, that's the way you want it, now, isn't it? You want it straight down the line and up front. Well, that is the way you getting it. The man
here say he stop it. Ain't right for grown folks to be as tan, biting at each other this way. Now, I know what I'm doing, Miss Liddy.
I want my store. And ain't a goddamn soul on this earth gonna keep me from getting a nod and got this close. I got a right to it. Done lived long enough, poor enough, to have me something.
I'm sorry. I wanted it as much as you did. Come on, Brother Holloway. You want to push those things to this end of the table for me, please? You know, it's funny. But I had gotten kind of used to the idea. I had figured out how I was going to say hello to the children and look at them when they come in with the pennies and all. Last night I was unpacking boxes in there, and I got to thinking about how nice it would be to have all them children just coming and going all the time. I ain't had no grands, I still. It was just me and Clarence. But I knew I'd have me some when we put out that sign. I'd just make them all my grandchildren. I know that sounds silly coming from somebody who never had chicken or child. But that's what it all meant to me.
Yeah, you gonna have your store, Miss Lidia. This is nothing but a setback. Something gonna turn up.
It ain't just the money. Not no more, it ain't. It's the spirit of the thing, Osteo. I done lost the spirit, and I'm scared now. I'm beginning to think like an old lady again.
Well, you're gonna just have to stop it. Now, we need for you to do this thing.
We?
Hey, all of us, we need it. It's important. Probably because it's so damn foolish. How much you need?
Now, I meant what I said, Estelle. Folks have to care about the way they leave here. And I can't promise to pay you back no money.
How much?
Oh, I don't know. Can't be more than $300-$400.
Three, four hundred? Is that all, woman? I thought you was talking about some money. That ain't nothing but chicken feed. One rally day down to Ebenezer get that, and it wouldn't be like borrowing, either.
A rally?
Ain't I the chairman of the deacon board? And I bet you Sarah's got some envelopes left over from the Women's Day rally in her pocketbook. It's time they did something for you. You's the church mother. Wouldn't hurt them none to show their appreciation.
You think it would be right and proper, though, for a church to be investing in business like that?
Lord, yes, the church can help. And they will, too. Now, I'm going to tell Sarah, because you know she's good at getting the people to do things they might not want to do. And the last rally day for the women ain't been but a couple weeks ago.
Oh, I'm going to tell Mr. Patterson. And folks wouldn't have to give less than they want to. That's the nice thing about a rally. And with everybody giving just a little bit, Mr. Patterson! Well, then you wouldn't have to be beholden to nobody. Yoo-hoo, Mr. Patterson! Oh, and we can pay it back. We could buy that communion chalice the pastor's been talking about as soon as the store start making some money. Oh, it sounds just fine.
Church? Oh, no. I couldn't go to the church for no help. Not now, I couldn't.
Well, I don't see why not. Wouldn't be like you're throwing the money away.
Well, you see what I mean? I ain't exactly what you call church folks. Oh, I don't doubt that they'd take up a collection or two for you, Miss Lydia, but I couldn't take it even if it did. Make my whole life out to be nothing but a lie.
You gonna quit?
I'm gonna think, Austell. That's right. Yeah. All the time thinking when you ought to be out there doing. Remember when I used to say that?
We done come up from home, and I say that to you all the time. Stick in the mud. Yeah. While I'd be running out there trying to see what I could get into, what I could make work. And old Estelle here, he be just a-sitting and thinking. Thinking and sitting. It's my turn now.
You going out?
Yep, gonna take this suit back to the man I borrowed it from.
That's right. Borrowed it from.
So much I got is borrowed, Miss Lydia. Even the stove. Somebody else's place. Yeah, then got so it's almost somebody else's dream. Even our Estelle done bought a piece of it. You know, some, I don't think that's quite right. I mean, to move in on people and give them things that ain't really theirs, that don't really belong to them, that they're doing just fine without. I mean, if it's really yours, you ought to be the one to work for it and make it real. Yeah, I heard myself when I come in here cussing and fussing. Because something I wanted was in danger. Something I made you want.
Oh, I do want the stove, Malon. I do want it, and we can have it.
Indeed you can. You got friends to help you, too.
Just start out a little smaller, that's all.
Well, I'll need your help. But later on, right now I'm going to have to do some figuring. See, can't I work this thing out to be the way it ought to be? Because if this lady and me going to be partners, we going to keep on pushing. Hmm? Ain't that right, yes, lady?
Whatever you want.
You know something? Something I just don't understand? How come you let somebody like me in your house in the first place?
Oh, go on. You're a fine man.
Yeah, but that ain't so. I can't let you put that on me because that's something I can't live up to, you know. The last words of Maitland Patterson should be, you ain't never learned to let a good thing go past.
You gonna be late?
I don't think so, but you lock up anyway, huh?
Wait a minute, can't you see me coming? Where is he going this time of night? Didn't you see me coming across the street?
Yeah, men folks got things to do in the early evening, if you want to know.
He went to take back a suit he borrowed from a man.
I should have known. He ain't had a place to get nothing what looked like anything.
You know, one of these days, you gonna open your mouth to say something and your tongue gonna cleave to the roof.
I ain't saying nothing I didn't say to his face. And besides, I didn't come over here to stay. I just come over here to get my copy of Jet that was mixed up in them papers I give you.
Oh, look upstairs in my bedroom. I was reading it.
Well, you want me to take this thing in the back?
If you please, Brother Holloway.
You know, you keep your faith in the Lord. Everything gonna be all right.
Thank you.
Since when you don't make your bed? Pillowcases every which way.
You know, I'm gonna see what they got over at that place on Diamond Street. Ain't so chinchy about what to throw away over there.
I made my bed. I know I did, because I got out a needle and thread and sewed up the corner of the pillowcase. I made my bed.
Well, what then?
The money. I put the money in the pillowcase. I told him that. I put it there so it would be safe and we'd have it for tomorrow. But I made my bed. I pulled all the covers up good and tight. Folded everything over real neat. I do that every morning. I made my bed.
Well, I'll be damned. Thank you.
Major funding for New Jersey Playhouse was provided by the New Jersey State Council on the Arts. Additional funding was provided by the Geraldine R. Dodge Foundation.